why dogs and cats live together. That's hysteria.
Wow.
Can you dig it?
Hey guys, welcome back to the Lucid Nightmare. I'm your host as always, Jay Schatzer. And today, I've got a fantastic fantasy animation film. It's from the 70s, and it's one of my all-time favorites. It's Jules Bass and Arthur Rankin Jr.'s 1977 hit, It's the Hobbit. And guys, this one's near and dear to my heart. So let's get right into this one, and here it is. The Hobbit. The Hobbit is a wonderfully magical animated feature in which brings J.R.R. Tolkien's heralded children's story to vivid life, introducing us to the world of Middle-earth and the heroes and creatures that inhabit it. Imagined in the most whimsical of ways, this fun adventure film moves at a brisk pace as we follow Bilbo on his journey from the Shire all the way to the Lonely Mountain and back again. With an abundance of musical sequences, character interactions, and action set pieces, this iteration of this classic novel is a must for any fan of the book, and it's a great setup for the live-action feature directed by Peter Jackson. If you're looking for a good old wholesome adventure tale, then The Hobbit is just up your alley. The film follows the story of Bilbo Baggins, a hobbit who has an unexpected series of visitors who sweep him up on a life-changing adventure, which changes him from a homebody into a courageous adventurer. After being visited by Gandalf the Wizard and a group of 13 dwarves, Bilbo reluctantly takes a job to be the party's burglar, in which he is tasked to retrieve some treasure from a dragon's lair. Setting out on their quest, the group encounters ravenous trolls, malevolent goblins, spiteful elves, devilish spiders, and a frighteningly cruel dragon named Smaug. As Bilbo rises to the occasion on all accounts, he learns that there is more to him than he realized, and that bravery and courage is something that can be found in the most smallest of creatures. This Rankin-Bass production is a real treat, especially for those that encountered it while still at a young age. For me, it was this entry and the Return of the King-produced Rankin-Bass collaboration that first sparked my imagination and put in motion my interest in reading Tolkien's writings. What Bass and Rankin were able to do with this production was perfectly capture the magic and wonder that is Tolkien's Middle-earth, while summarizing quite nicely the contents that can be found within The Hobbit's novelization. Most everything from the book is intact, including the three troll sequence, the capture of the party by the Goblin King, Bilbo and Gollum's riddles in the dark, and even the death of Smaug by the Bowman Bard. The only glaring admission that was missing from this production was the inclusion of Bjorn, a hulking man that can transform into a bear. Other than that, I would say that Rankin and Bass did quite well with jamming everything into this film's 90-minute runtime, without compromising the story's integrity or spirit. As for the visual style of this feature, I'd say that it perfectly mirrors the quality that one would imagine if depicting the aged world of Middle-earth. The designs for the creatures and characters created by Lester Abrams are magical, and the overall look of the world is quite captivating, even in its child-centric presentation. The detail and tone of this version is also an inviting one, as it features an aesthetic that seems pulled from legend. It's easy to say that the source material is geared towards children, and the overall scope of the narrative pales in the comparison with the epic quest featured in The Lord of the Rings, but what The Hobbit establishes right from the get-go is a definitive style that harkens back to a fictional world that feels lived in and genuine, be it a more whimsical and fantasy-driven one. The music is also something of an underrated gem, giving both the foreboding doom of Smaug's lair and the carefree nature of Bilbo's Shire lifestyle some much-needed depth and validity. The original music composed by Maury Laws is extremely effective for this particular fantasy piece, and he definitely is able to capture the wonder of Middle-earth in even the most sparing of time. What might throw some people off of the film is that it is quite musical in the folk music sense of things, where characters will begin going off on song-filled tangents. In actuality, there is an abundance of poetry-like verses in the book, so for me, it only adds to the charm of the film. Not only that, but the songs get stuck in your head, particularly the main title theme, The Greatest Adventure, written and performed by Glenn Yarbrough, and the fan favorite, That's What Bilbo Baggins Hates. To each their own, but for me, the jovial ways in which the film bursts into song every once in a while makes this iteration of Token's classic that much more fun to watch. It must be said that, for all its content, the film moves at a surprisingly brisk pace as it sprints from one set piece to the next. We never really dwell in one particular situation for more than a moment, making the film feel more of a summary of the book rather than a fleshed-out telling of the characters' experiences. Be that as it may, I enjoy the rampant pace of the production, and even though things aren't expanded upon, other than what is said on the written page, I still get a ridiculous amount of enjoyment from this whimsical tale of a hobbit and his unexpected journey. The Hobbit is a wonderful Rankin-Bass collaboration that really nails the spirit and passion of Tolkien's book. With its expressive style and unique character design, the film paints a beautiful picture, one in which never wanes after multiple viewings. Childish in its very nature, but respectfully depicted, The Hobbit is a justifiably fast-paced adventure film, which takes the iconic set pieces of the novel and just runs with it. With its stupendously vivid original music, composed by Maury Laws, to its original character design created by Lester Abrams, this animated adaptation is a treasured piece of Tolkien history. If you've ever wondered what a fast-paced animated version of Bilbo Baggins' unexpected journey would look like, then give this one a go. It's a ridiculous amount of fun, and the carefree nature of it is just a blast. It also doesn't hurt if you have a little nostalgia to back it up. The Rankin-Bass adaptation of The Hobbit is a Tolkien treat. And there you have it, guys. Rankin-Bass's great, great adaptation of The Hobbit. And quite frankly, this is probably my favorite version, my favorite film version of The Hobbit. Peter Jackson did an alright job with his trilogy, but this one's always going to be on the top of my humble opinion. But guys, that's it for me today. Hope you enjoyed that one. Like I said, it was one of my favorites as a kid, and I still enjoy it today. But if you like what I'm doing here, guys, please like and subscribe. And if you have time, leave a comment below, because I'd love to hear from you. But until then, I will see you at the next movie review. Take care.
The greatest adventure is what lies ahead. Today and tomorrow are yet.